Chapter 8. Can we all become rich? One of Arcot's friends said, "So, you became rich because you were lucky that Algamish made you his heir. But what about us who do not know any Algamish? Do we have any hope?" Arcot replied, "Have you forgotten what I said about Lady Luck or Fickle Fate? Yes, I was lucky, but only because I had a desire to prosper before I met Algamish. Opportunity is a snobbish and impatient goddess who wastes no time with those who are not prepared. Do you think Algamish would have entrusted his properties to me if I was not capable?" Another friend spoke up. "Arcad, if what you told us is true, it seems that it's so simple to become rich. If it's really that simple that everyone could do it, then there won't be enough wealth to go around." Arcad assured them, "Friends, you seem to think that wealth is limited. But I tell you, the world is abundant. Wealth is created wherever men exert energy and do work. If a rich man builds himself a new castle, is the gold he pays gone? No. The brickmaker has part of it. The laborer has part of it. Everyone who labors upon the castle has part of it. When it is completed, is it not worth all its costs? And is the ground upon which it stands not worth more because it is there? Even the ground beside it is now worth more because the castle is there. Wealth grows in magical ways. No one can predict the limit of it. Have we not built our great city of Babylon on dry land?" Now wondering, another friend asked, "What then can you advise us so that we may become rich? The years have passed and we are no longer young, and we still have nothing saved." Despite the despair in his friend's voice, Arcad was full of hope when he said to all of them, "I advise you to take the wisdom of Algamish and save yourselves. A part of all I earn is mine to keep. I pay myself first. Say it in the morning when you wake up. Say it at noon. Say it at night. Say it every hour of each day. Say it to yourself until the words stand out like letters of fire across the sky." Arcad continued, and these were his passionate words. Counsel with wise men. Seek the advice of men whose daily work is handling money. Let them save you from the mistake I made in entrusting my money to Asmur, the brickmaker. Learn to make your treasure work for you. Make it your slave. Make its children and its children's children work for you. Ensure an income for your future. Look at the old people and remember that you, too, will grow old. Therefore, invest your treasure carefully. Don't believe those who promise easy and fast money. They are usually desperate and will just leave you broke. Only take risks that you and your family can comfortably take. Provide also that your family may be protected should you die unexpectedly. For such protection, it's possible to set aside small payments at regular intervals. But remember to enjoy life. Do not overstrain yourself trying to save too much. If 1/10 of all you earn is as much as you can comfortably keep now, be content to keep this portion for the moment and increase as you go on. Live within your means, but don't be a niggard who's afraid to spend and unable to enjoy the fruits of his labor. Life is good and life is rich with worthwhile things to enjoy.